Hey, what's up, it's Kira, and welcome back to another Dauntless video. So in today's video, I'm gonna be breaking down the behemoth, Savit, which is a new behemoth, which came in patch 1.8.3, which came out on, like, 2nd of December. But before we get right into the behemoth breakdown, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, it really helps me out a lot, and you can always unsubscribe later. Also, large portion of my viewers are not subscribed to the channel, so if you do, I'd really appreciate it. Now let's get right into the breakdown. First of all, Savit is a new behemoth, which came in patch 1.8.3 in Dauntless. And in my opinion, it's a really cool behemoth. It's a shock behemoth that spawns in Brightwood, Cold Runner Key, and Cave Fury, and every escalation, because it's a normal behemoth. Instead of an event behemoth, which was like the Felnex or the Bloodshot Shroud. Now for the behemoth movesets. In his normal mode, he has four moves. First is forward slash. When you're in front of the behemoth, Savit dashes forward towards the player, dealing damage and covering a good distance. And it's also similar to Togedoro's Flame Punch. Also a quick tip, it likes to do this attack a lot, so keep in mind that when you're fighting Savit, prepare to dodge a lot. And do you wanna like, for the best experience, you wanna go for the chain blades because it has better dodge. Next up is backflip slashes, which is when you're behind the behemoth, it does a backflip and slashes the ground next to him, spawning lightning on its sides. Next up is close slash. When you're close to the behemoth, Savit does a close range attack. It's a like little slash in front of him, so you can dodge really easily. And the last attack is a spinning slash, which Savit spins when you're close to it. It's like a close slash, but it spins around. Now let's continue into the Aether Charge mode. The attack it gains from this Aether Charge mode is Shockblade Throw. When Savit is in its Aether Charge mode, it powers up and throws Shockblades, kind of like Karabok does. And all the other attacks stay the same. Lastly, it's Rage mode. First on the list for the Rage mode attacks is Shock Ground Slam. Savit powers up and slams the ground with its empowered blades, doing shock damage to nearby slayers. It gets stuck after dodging this attack, so you can go and do some damage while it's stuck. Also, while it's in rage mode, it does all the other attacks but a bit differently. For example, it does a couple of slashes while close to the behemoth instead of one. And the forward slash also covers more ground. So this was all about the movesets of the behemoth, and now let's continue into the weapons and gear. Firstly, let's talk about the unique effect of the Savit's weapons. Savit's weapons are, in my opinion, the best shock weapons before the Malkarion weapons. Its unique effect throws a boomerang kind of thing that does a moderate amount of damage, and its cooldown is 60 seconds. Also, all the weapons have pulse and two technique cells that you can use. For the armor, the helmet and torso have tactician cells, which are new cells to the game, and helmet has inside cell slot, and the torso has alacrity cell slot. The gauntlets have a relentless and alacrity cell slot. The legs have assassin's frenzy and technique cell slot. And yeah, all in all, this behemoth, in my opinion, is really cool and has really unique design. Aside from the skeletal feature of Togedoro, but it's a good original behemoth. And yeah, that was all about the behemoth of which is Savit. If you want to keep up to date to more of Dauntless content and know more about the game, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, it really helps me a lot, and you can always unsubscribe later. This has been Giora, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.